In this tutorial, I'll show you how to create this scene in 5 minutes. Let's select the cube, and type, G, Z, and, 1, to align its bottom with the world center. Let's move its origin to the 3D cursor, so we can freely scale the mesh like this. I'll create a ground plane and scale it. We need one more plane to use as a cloth object. I'll type, G, and, Z, to move it upward like this. Unlike regular physics objects, the obstacles cannot be rigid body passive objects. They need to be set as the collision objects instead. If we use the rigid body, the cloth physics will drop right through them. We must set all surrounding obstacles as collision physics objects. Next thing to remember is to add more geometry to the cloth object. If we don't, this issue will occur. More geometry on the cloth object means more realism on the physics side. We need to have a lot of geometry to make this work. Next thing to remember is to right-click the mesh to shade smooth. We can add more geometry, or use the subsurf modifier. Please don't add too much geometry, because that will slow the scene down. I have added a subsurf modifier, and watch how slow the animation has become. Let's use the sky texture. I'll set up the render scene and start to add the materials. When I selected the cloth, the inner cube was selected. I'll add a shiny material, and use it on the cloth object. I'll turn off use nodes under compositing, and use 16 samples to render in cycles. I'm only using 16 samples to save time. Please use at least 128 samples to make it look good. This is the end of the tutorial. Thank you for watching.